Hey, what is up, you guys? Quentin Loves Trains and Horror Movies 2015, and today I'm going to be reviewing Halloween Resurrection, released in 2002. This is the last of continuity that goes from the original Halloween to Halloween 2, Halloween H2O, to this one. After that, the series would rest for 16 years before the making of Halloween 2018. Halloween Resurrection is another popular contender for the worst of the series, which is interesting seeing how it was directed by Rick Rosenthal, the same dude who helmed Halloween 2, a sequel that many people loved. And why is Resurrection so widely panned? Well, maybe it's because it negates the excellent ending the series could have had with H2O's finale. Maybe it's because, in retrospect, the film's reliance on the burgeoning world of webcams in cyberspace seems quaint. Or maybe it's because it features rapper Busta Rhymes. As a reality TV host and karate enthusiast, all those things and many more missteps contribute to another Halloween I wish I could run away from. But at least it's got some decent kills. We will now get to reviewing this movie. Following the murders at Hillcrest Academy, a guilt-ridden and traumatized Laurie Strode has been confined to a psychiatric facility after killing a man whom she had mistaken for her murderous brother, Michael Myers. As two nurses talk about what happened, flashbacks reveal that a paramedic had found an unconscious Michael in the school before he suddenly awakened and attacked the paramedic by crushing his larynx, so that he could not speak. Michael then swapped clothes with the unconscious paramedic and left the school grounds undetected. As Laurie drove in the ambulance she believed Michael Myers was in. On October 31st, 2001, after 3 years of hiding, Michael re-emerges to attempt to murder Laurie again, who has been institutionalized at the Grace Anderson Sanitarium. Expecting his arrival, Laurie sets up a trap for him. After killing two security guards, Michael attacks and chases Laurie to the institution's rooftop, where her trap works and temporarily incapacitates Michael. However, Laurie's fears of killing the wrong person again get the better of her, and when she tries to remove his mask to confirm his identity, Michael stabs and throws her off the rooftop to her death. A year later, college students Sarah Moyer, Bill Woodlick, Donna Chang, Jen Danzig, Jim Morgan, and Rudy Grimes win a competition to appear on an internet reality show called Dangertainment, directed by Freddie Harris and Nora Winston, in which they have to spend a night in Michael's abandoned childhood house in order to figure out what led him to kill. However, while setting up cameras throughout the house in preparation for the show, cameraman Charlie is killed by Michael, who has returned to Haddonfield. On Halloween night, equipped with head cameras, Sarah, Bill, Donna, Jen, Jim, and Rudy enter the house to separate into three groups to search for clues. While Sarah's messaging, friend Deckard watches the live broadcast during a party. During the search, Michael suddenly appears and kills Bill. Donna and Jim discover a wall filled with fake corpses and realize that the show is a setup. Before the former is killed by Michael, at the party, Deckard and other partygoers witness the murder, but only Deckard realizes that it was real. Meanwhile, Freddy enters the house dressed as Michael in order to scare the competitors and is followed by the real Michael, whom he mistakes for Charlie. When Rudy, Sarah, and Jim find Freddy in the Michael costume, he reveals the scheme to them and begs them to cooperate, telling them that they will all be paid well if the show works out. After Freddy leaves, the trio decides to gather up the rest of their friends and leave. Jen discovers Bill's corpse, and Michael decapitates her in front of Rudy. Sarah and Jim, who soon realize that it isn't Freddy, Michael proceeds to kill Jim and Rudy before chasing Sarah upstairs. Locking herself in a bedroom, Sarah begs for Deckard to help her, as the other party goers realize that all the murders were real. Deckard begins to message Sarah on Michael's location to help her avoid him. Sarah runs into Freddy just as Michael finds them and stabs the latter. Sarah runs into the tunnels and finds an exit leading to the garage where she discovers Nora's body. Michael again arrives and attacks Sarah, but a still living Freddy finds them and fights Michael as an electrical fire starts in the garage. After electrocuting Michael, Freddy carries Sarah to safety, leaving Michael to die in the burning garage. Later, Freddy and Sarah are interviewed by the local news, during which Sarah thanks Deckard for saving her life. Meanwhile, Michael is presumed dead and his body is taken to the morgue. However, as the coroner prepares to examine his body, Michael suddenly awakens. That's it. Halloween Resurrection came out in 2002 and was poorly received, and I also want to give a shout out to Christian Hanna Horror, Nick the Lost River Drive-In, Rhine 1988, Lee Drum Dums, Pizzal, Braden Timmons, Nick Pushes Horror Channel, Jake Blaster Production, Bud and Halloween Verse, Dave McRae, Jimmy Champagne, Zach CZ's World, Mike and Jay, We Watched a Movie, and James A. Janisse from Dead Meat. Next week, I'll be reviewing Halloween 2018. Until next time, I'm Quentin Loves Trains and Horror Movies 2015. Please like, share, subscribe, comment below on what you think. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and support me on Patreon. Thanks, be good people.